But one important thing that we need to know that as women, the women movement has reached where it has reached in Uganda through caucusing. We caucus on most of the pertinent issues. When we get laws, bills which come before parliament, we pick out the issues, we synthesize the issues which affect the women, we agree, we come together as women. Actually, politics is women. We recognize ourselves as women first, then other issues follow. So when there is an issue, we caucus and agree, and each party brings in, but then we agree that as women, this is our issue and this is what we should articulate. So I'm calling on all other women in other parliaments which don't have caucus, women caucuses. Please get together, sit as women, identify issues, cross-cutting issues which affect the women, and then we shall be able to move the gender agenda ahead. Thank you very much.
We came to the parliament, we started to Majlis Ashura in January 2013. It's a new experience. I guess we were very honored by the royal decree and by being selected be appointed in the parliament, but at the same time it's a journey that we need to be prepared for, and we need to work hard in order to make it successful, because somehow it happened that we were the first ladies, and unless we create a model that is acceptable by the society for them to carry on and to reach the target of 50-50, we need to work very hard. So the acceptance of women being involved in politics by the rest of the society was one of the challenges that we need to take care or to tackle, but we need to tackle it very carefully, because again, you want to move slowly but surely. Another thing was we felt an isolation for some time, being here at the IPU and meeting all these wonderful women and the group of women parliamentarians that happened to know about their activities and their product, the Iknow Politics. I think that was magnificent in the sense that it would help us and all the new parliamentarians to know something about how to prepare themselves, how to be really active and actively engaged in moving things forwards in their country.
We started a special institutional strengthening program, and within this program we included a program to get more women into politics, specifically into parliament. We know, however, that in order to really make sure that we get more women in parliament, we need to have a strategy. And so we have two lines along which we work. One is that we contacted the political parties, the parliament did that, and asked them to send us their women, to give them the floor. And we received about 30 women active in the political parties. And we opened the meeting room of the parliament to them, the chamber, and they received the opportunity to speak for a few minutes. And it was very empowering. The women were powerful speakers. They were very active in politics. They had, they were professionals, they were leaders in their fields, but still, I asked the parties, where were these women? Why are you hiding them? And so, this is one of the ways we try to get the women on the forefront, and the other strategy we have is to see if we can implement the quota legislation, but we don't have full support for that as yet. So I have asked my international colleagues of the region, parliamentarians, COPA, to support Suriname and to come to the meeting of women parliamentarians in May, that we will have the parliamentarians meeting in Paramaribo.
There are lots of challenges that women face in politics, not only in Afghanistan, in many countries of the world. But the main challenges that women face in Afghanistan in politics field is the security. We have network with different countries of parliament, but unfortunately, to the extent that we need, so far we have not been able to achieve that. So I'm hoping that we can have more networks with different parliamentarians of the world. At the same time, I believe that politics is governing everyone's life, including the younger generation. And most of country, the majority of their population consists of the younger generation. So for that reason, it's very essential for younger generation to get involved in politics. Because in any case, their life has been governed by politics. It's much better for them to get involved in politics and shape the future and their rights by their own voice. Thank you.
I think women need more. Women have not the possibility to do networking as men are doing. And therefore, it is good to have our own women network. And I would wish to support this, other women to come into politics, especially young women. I know that it's not easy to have both politics and perhaps family and children. But it is a good work to do in politics. You can move something, and you are responsible for a certain subject to bring forward. And I think this is good for your own life, but also for the lives of the women in your country and in all nations of the world.
وجود البرلمانيات في كتلة برلمانية يساعد على رفع قدرات البرلمانيات من التحديات التي تواجه البرلمانيات في دولنا العربية هي يعني ارتباطهم بناخبينهم في الدوائر الجغرافية أو ناخبينهم على مستوى الولايات وهذا يتطلب عمل مزدوج للبرلمانية تقوم بعمل في مجتمعها لأن المجتمع يطالب بأنها تساهم معه في تنمية المجتمع وأيضا مطالب بأن تقوم بدورها داخل قبة البرلمان من تشريعات ومن سل قوانين ومن دورها الرقابي على أجهزة الدولة التنفيذية الفرص الآن أصبح هنالك وعي كبير جدا في مجتمعاتنا العربية والإسلامية السمح لمشاركة متزايدة للنساء في مواقع اتخاذ القرار حصص الكوتا أتاحت فرص كبيرة للنساء بالتمثيل وكسرت حاجز الدعم البرلمان دعم المواطنين أو دعم الرجال لترشيح النساء فوجود كوتا مثلا في السودان بدأت الكوتا بأن تكون هنالك قائمة للنساء يصوت لها النساء وكان هذا في الفترة من 2001 2005 ولكن برلمان 2010 كانت هنالك كوتا ولكن التصويت للرجال والنساء ونتوقع أن تكون في المرحلة القادمة وفي الانتخابات القادمة أن تكون هنالك نساء في دوائر جغرافية وفي قوائم الحزبية لأننا نعتقد أن الحاجز النفسي تصويت الرجل للمرأة قد انكسر بتصويته لها في قائمة نسائية رسالتي لأخواتي وبناتي الشباب لا بد أن تقتحموا ولا بد أن يكون هنالك يعني عزيمة قوية جدا تفتح لكم المسارات العمل السياسي عمل مضني وعمل شاق وعمل ليس فيه مردود مادي ولكنه يشبع كثير من الرغبات ولكنه يشبع يعني يعطي الإنسان الشعور بأنه ساهم في بناء وطنه ولذلك على رسالة للفتيات أن يقومن بتدريب أنفسهن بالاحتكاك بمن هن أكبر منهن سنا بالجلوس في مجالس الذين يسبقونهم بخبرات بالطلب والاستفسار أو الأسئلة للذين سبقوهم في مجالات مختلفة وهذا الاقتحام وهذه المبادرات تجعل من البنات الشابات اليوم هم قيادات المرأة وقيادات لا أقول قيادات المرأة ولكن أقول قيادات لمجتمعات لأن المرأة الآن يعني قريبا جدا ستصبح قيادية وأنا بدأت تجربتي بعملي في اتحادات الطلاب ثم في اتحادات المرأة ثم في العمل البرلماني وتدرجت حتى أن وصلت بالانتخاب للنائب الأول لرئيس البرلمان العربي وأقود وفود البرلمانية من الرجال والنساء في المحافل الدولية وهذا ربما يكون محفز لكثير من النساء في المرحلة القادمة شكرا
أو Our main focus in Sierra Leone is to promote women issue. We currently have free health care for women and children, lactating moms, pregnant women. We're looking forward to work with more women and in bring women in decision making. Why is it important to bring women in decision making? We have 52% of female population in our country, and we feel that with more women in decision making, whether it's in the police, army, or in politics, as long as they're making decisions on behalf of the country, will help to improve the status of women, but also incorporate very important issues which are gender sensitive to us. It is very important that we have passed the disabled law. Our main priorities as female in parliament now is to make sure these laws are enforced and to make outreach programs to other parliamentarians or other parts of the country so that people will be aware. People will not suffer in silence. Women will not be beaten, injured, maimed by their partners, all unnoticed or unpunished. So these are our campaigns that we're doing in our country.
Մեր կուսակցությունում ավելացել է կանանց թիվը պարլամենտում եւ ընդհանրապես ազգային ժողովում 14 կին է առաջվա 9 կնոջ փոխարեն, այսինքն դա իհարկե 10% է կազմում, բայց մենք ամեն ինչ անելու ենք, որ կանանց թիվը ավելի ներկայանալի լինի։ Նաեւ ուզում եմ ասել, որ մենք այս տարի արդեն ընդունեցինք կանանց եւ տղամարդկանց հավասար իրավունքների եւ հավասար հնարավորությունների մասին օրենքի նախագիծը ամբողջությամբ, որտեղ շատ մեծ տեղ է հատկացվում կանանց դերակատարությանը, եւ ընդհանրապես մեր աշխատանքը եւ միջազգային կառույցների հետ, դա բրիտանական խորհուրդն է, նա NDI-ն է, բոլոր այդ կառույցների հետ, որոնք զբաղվում են կանանց խնդիրներով, մենք ունենք նաեւ պարլամենտական միջկուսակցական խումբ, որը աշխատում է տարբեր կուսակցությունների կանանց հետ եւ իրականում միասին շատ ծրագրեր ենք իրականացնում։ Հույս ունեմ եւ լիա հույս եմ, որ հետագայում էլ կանանց ներկայացվածությունը եւ գործադիր մարմնում եւ պարլամենտում գնալով կավելանա։ Շնորհակալություն։
هناك يعني مجال مفتوح الان مع العولمه مع الانفتاح مع ايضا تحديات التي هي مطروحه الان على مستوى العالم. تحدياتنا أيضا في الجزائر أن المرأة الجزائرية وخاصة المرأة في مجال السياسة لابد أن تكون موجودة بقوة وبكثرة، وهو ما يجعل اليوم نحن في الاتحاد البرلماني الدولي الجزائر تعتبر اليوم الرائدة من حيث تمثيل النساء في السياسة وفي البرلمان بالمرتبة الأولى 146 امرأة، يمثل نسبة 31.6%. هذه يعني تحدي تشالنج كبير تم تحقيقه في 2012، ونحن نصبو دائما إلى أن نكون في الطليعة، نكون سباقين، لأن هذا ليس هو مصير النساء فقط بقدر هو مصير مجتمعاتنا العربية والإسلامية، هو تواصل مستمر فيما بين الشعوب، فيما بين الثقافات والحضارات. وأظن أنه أجمل وأفضل وأنبل مجال يمكن أن تسعى من ورائه المرأة للوصول إلى تغيير الوضع العام، تطوير مجتمعاتنا، هو من ولوجها مجال السياسة وعالم السياسة، لأنه في كثير من الأوقات كان الرجال هم الذين يقررون، والآن تدخل المرأة ويدخل النساء، تدخل النساء من هذا الباب الكبير من البرلمان حتى تقول كلمتها وحتى تصنع القرار، مصدر القرار الذي كان كما قلت من مجال الرجال. أيضا هناك تشريع بالمجال الثقافي التربوي والصحي والتضامني. إذن المرأة بحكم أنها حساسة وبحكم أنها واعية ربما أكثر من غيرها بمشاكل مجتمعاتها في المجال التربوي والصحي والإنساني، إذن كل هذه مواضيع نثيرها.
e é a primeira vez que eu participo numa assembleia da UIP. Para mim é muito importante porque nós, mulheres angolanas, estamos a lutar para que nos inserimos mais na política angolana. Tomamos posto a pontos de decisões do nosso país. É assim que eu estou aqui a representar a juventude angolana nesses fóruns, que julgo ser muito imperioso, bastante importante para nós, uma vez que podemos ali contribuir sobre aquilo que são os nossos problemas. O esforço que eu gostaria que os Estados fizessem neste momento é haver maior diálogo com a juventude. O nosso Estado tem feito bastante, isto tem nos ajudado bastante. A juventude tem tido uma participação ativa no nosso país. Eu, como mulher, julgo ser ainda imperioso a luta contínua desta inclusão de mulheres ao Parlamento e nos postos de decisão do país, como eu já disse. Eu gostava de deixar uma recomendação aos jovens que lutem, que estejam inseridos em organizações para participarem, para poderem contribuir, para poderem sugerir sobre aquilo que são os nossos problemas, aquilo que nós podemos fazer como mulheres. E julgo eu, estou muito feliz por trabalhar onde eu trabalho, estar no sítio onde eu estou, como mulher parlamentar, para defender os interesses da juventude. Sempre trabalhei com jovens e gosto de trabalhar porque eu acho que é uma forma de contribuir para que todos nós juntos possamos contribuir no desenvolvimento sustentável, econômico e social do nosso país.
Somos muchas mujeres, también hemos tenido la participación en el Parlamento, somos 57 diputados y diputadas. Creo que hemos tenido mucha participación. También estoy muy orgullosa porque nuestra presidenta es una mujer, primera en la historia, doña Laura Chinchilla Miranda. Y hemos tenido oportunidades para desenvolvernos, para demostrar nuestra capacidad, nuestro trabajo, trabajar en equipo y empoderamiento. Hemos tocado temas muy importantes, hemos aprobado proyectos de ley muy importantes a nivel de turismo, a nivel de salud, a nivel de educación. Así que hemos estado trabajando en ambos proyectos importantes para el país. Seguiremos trabajando en equipo porque tenemos un compromiso, una solidaridad, una trayectoria para sacar a nuestro país adelante, para que sea más desarrollado y para que tengamos menos problemas de los que tenemos.
I'm the Vice Chairperson for Women Caucus, and in our strategic plan, the first thing that we are doing is to motivate girls so that they enter into politics. And another thing that I can say, according to what recommendation I can make for the young girls, is to tell them that they have to make sure that they get good education, they get access to education, because it's only education that will bring them into the politics. One of the major achievements that we have made is to increase the number of women in the parliament. For example, we started like in 1% when we got independence, but of recent we have 30, almost like 7% women. So you can see that the number of women is increasing. And right now we are in the process of reviewing the constitution. We are going to have our new constitution next year. And one of the things that we are pushing is to make sure that women's rights are really in the new constitution. So we think that in 2015, in the coming general election 2015, we'll have more women. Because one of the things, although we have the affirmative action, we now want to have different ways of achieving 50-50. And that will go like having the proportional representation, but also we are looking for maybe having a party list whereby each constituency or each district will have one woman and one man. So by that, we think that we'll reach the 50-50 by the next election.
Also, one challenge is to have more young people in the parliament and in the politics for all. Because I think young people, they have so much
more to on their agenda, but I hope they will give some time to work with politics. And it's my advice to them is never give up. It's democratic take times, and it should take times, because it shouldn't be too a quick fix. It's better to take a good debate and let it take the time. So I hope the young people don't will rush on everything.